Welcome to your effective back of thighs sculpt workout. Hello everybody, my name is Rebecca-Louise and today we are really gonna work on those hamstrings and we have a brand new set for you. Guys, I want you to let me know in the comments how much you love this new set. Tell me all the things and why you love it. All right guys, and we're gonna get started and working those hamstrings. Let's get started with a nice little warm up to get us started. We're just gonna bring those hips out to the side, bring that knee in towards the chest. Quick 2 minute warm up and then we're gonna go straight into it. So these, I absolutely love working my hamstrings. So we're gonna be in for a treat today. I'm gonna push us to the max. We've got 40 seconds of exercise. We got a 20 second rest. Remember, in that 20 second rest, I'm gonna give you something to do. If you wanna do it, if you wanna take that rest, no problem. But we wanna use weights today that are gonna challenge you. Get a couple of different weights near you. Somebody was asking me the other day, like, when do I keep increasing my weight? What you wanna do is you wanna increase the weight as it starts to get easier for you, right? Last couple of reps should be challenging and no, you are not going to bulk up. All right, we're gonna bring one leg in front. We're gonna stretch it all the way up, lifting up to the sky. Take it over to the other side. So just bringing that foot up, feeling that stretch all through the backs of your legs, all through the backs of the calves. And here we go. All right, what is our topic for today? We're gonna go through a little bit of mindset today, a little bit of nutrition. And of course, we're gonna get that workout in at the same time. So I'm gonna talk to you as we go. Follow along with workouts. This is what you love. This is what it's all about. Give me one more on that right side, which other side is your final side. Lift up and squeeze. Okay, we're just gonna take it down nice and low and come underneath. So just warming up a little bit of those inner thighs at the same time. And we are just gonna get focused today. That's what it's all about, is having fun. All right, if you're not having fun, you're doing it wrong. That's what it's all about. And life wants to be that rhythm of fun, enjoyment. It's not to say that, you know, you're not gonna have things that happen to you throughout the day, but if you cannot allow them to affect you so much, if you can just push through a little bit more and come with it from a positive attitude, it's gonna be way easier and happier every single day when you wake up in the morning. All right, let's come all the way back up to standing. We're gonna raise up onto those heels, onto the balls of the feet, bringing those heels up, squeeze and all the way down. So that's it, just slightly rocking back, lifting those toes up, and then all the way down, pushing down into the ground, and then here we go. Inhale through your nose, exhale everything out, get that breathing, so important, right? Hydrate, breathe, and stretch to get ourselves focused for today. Last one, and release. All right, shake it out, shake it out, shake it out. We're gonna do a quick little inner thigh stretch right here. So bring one knee out to the side, we're just gonna hold it up right here for 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, come over to the other side, feeling that stretch. Make sure you've got your water, make sure you've got your weight, make sure you've got everything close to you. Come it over to one more side. Either way, holding that stretch. Here we go for 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, back over to the other side. And then we're gonna pulse it out for the last 10 seconds, backwards and forwards. Here we go, so pushing that knee out, squeezing that glute, lifting up through the chest, getting yourself fired up for today's workout. This is what we're doing, this is what we're gonna make happen, and release. All right, let's get fired up for today's workout. We're gonna start off with my favorite exercise. We're gonna take it into some deadlifts. I absolutely love working my hamstrings, my friends. So you guys are in for a real treat. And we're gonna have a fun little theme throughout our videos, all about mindset. So we're talking about rhythm. Today we're gonna be talking about something else to really help us get that positive mindset. So bring those feet hip width distance apart, squeeze those glutes. You're gonna drop it down to halfway through your shins, push down to the ground and then squeeze. So if you're on the BTES app, you're also gonna get that warm up and cool down and the full length version. So make sure that you've also done that. And then we're gonna take it through a nice workout today to really fire up and shake the back of our legs. So once we get those hamstrings nice and toned, it's also gonna help get that perky booty. All right, push down into the ground, tucking those hips under and squeeze those glutes. Here we go. Now think about when you're holding these weights, aim to also activate your lats right here, okay? So not just dropping everything down, squeezing everything tight. Give me one more, all the way, push down to the ground and squeeze. All right, next exercise. You're gonna kind of bring your legs, one foot is gonna be in front of the other. You're gonna bring up the back heel. You're gonna take it all the way down halfway, push into the ground and then squeeze those glutes. So basically, you've probably got like a foot distance. That front leg is straight. You're gonna bend down, as you're pushing that booty back and then squeeze all the way up to the top. So feel that nice stretch all the way through down into your hamstrings and then tucking those hips underneath. All right, take a nice inhale and then exhale everything down. So today we're gonna talk about what happens when the universe sends us a little test and it tries to throw us off our game. How would you feel if the things happened that you feel like they happened to you, they actually were happening for you as a way to help you grow? And what we're gonna do is we're gonna work on that today, the mindset that you get to have to just live every single day fired up and excited. And when something happens that can try and throw us off our game, we don't let it. How would you feel if you were able to do that? Well, I'm gonna give you all the tools to make that happen. All right, we're gonna take it over to the other side. So we're gonna bring that back heel up. So right now we've got our left leg in front. That's gonna stay nice and straight. Let's just do a couple of practice ones right here. So halfway down, all of the tension right there is in that front glute, lifting up through your chest in 3, 2, 1. Here we go. So take it down, push into the ground, and then squeeze that glute underneath. Now pull that core in nice and tight and activate your lats at the same time. That's it. Upper body is engaged. Take it down halfway. Just think about really feeling in that stretch, then pull and then squeeze, tuck underneath. That's it. Here we go. All the way down. Inhale through your nose and exhale everything out. Now I'm just demonstrating here with 5 pound weights. Typically I can have like 45 pounds in my hands. I can hip thrust 300 pounds is my record so far. But it's not necessarily about how much weight that you are lifting. It's about making sure that that form is correct. But that just goes to show you that even if I can hip thrust 300 pounds, whoo, you are definitely not gonna bulk up, my friends. Give me one more and squeeze. All right, we're gonna take it into a fun little arabesque lift. So you're gonna use one weight here. You can add in two weights if you prefer, but for balance, I'm gonna hold one right here. We're gonna pull that core in nice and tight. We're gonna turn that leg out and we're gonna take it up and down just like so. So really thinking about using the back of your hamstrings right here, your hamstrings, back of the leg, standing up nice and tall, bringing that weight down here will actually make you feel that resistance a little bit more in that leg. That's it. So squeeze those glutes, lifting up through your chest, breathing in through your nose, and exhale everything out. We're doing so great, everybody. Here we go. We're gonna fly through this workout. Trust me, every single time that we show up to do a workout, right, we're gonna just gonna fly through it because we're gonna be having fun. And that's what we're talking about, is if you are not having fun, you are doing it wrong, right? So every day when we wake up and things try to like knock us up our path, when they knock us off our mindset, right, we get to decide how we react to it. Because it's not what happens to us, it's how we react. All right, now we're gonna take it over to the other side. Oh my goodness, my booty is already on fire. So you wanna turn out that leg and bring it up and down. Bringing that hand right on the hip is just gonna help you with your adjustment. So you've got 10 seconds right here. Now lean forward just a little bit more, turning out that leg. Give me one practice one, lifting up, and nice work. All right, here we go, we're ready to flow. So how do you feel when something doesn't quite go your way? Do you like fly off the handle? Is your reactions actually what's ruining your day? Because sometimes, often in life, it's not actually what's happening for us, it's how we react to things. So maybe just think about something that's happened recently where you just got so emotional, it threw you off your path, and you were like, oh my goodness, like I didn't realize how much this changed my day. And I could have just thought about it differently and it wouldn't have changed anything. Because things are gonna happen for us every single day. And if we look at them, instead of good or bad, it's just experiences to grow from. It's amazing what the changing in your state of happiness can be every single day. All right, we're gonna come into a nice wide deadlift and we're gonna raise our heels at the top. So bring that weight back together. Taking that wide, you're gonna have both of those toes facing towards me. Slight bend in the knee, you're gonna come all the way down and then you're gonna lift all the way up onto those balls of the feet. Here we go, 3, 2, 1, let's go. So take it down, booty is back, lifting up through the chest and then up onto those toes. Nice work, everybody. Slow, control, focus, passion, excitement. Remember, we're having fun right now. We wanna have fun. It is fun, moving our body. You get to move your body right now. It's gonna make you feel younger. It's gonna give you more years of your life. It's gonna help you boost your metabolism. It's gonna get you energized. It's gonna boost your metabolism. It's gonna give you more energy. And you're gonna feel great. So why not? Why is this not fun right now? But the more of this workout that you do, the better you are going to feel. All right, 3, 2, 1, and squeeze. All right, we're gonna go back to the top. We're gonna take it all the way through again from those deadlifts. So bring those feet hip width distance apart. Squeeze those glutes nice and tight. Lifting up through your chest and just taking a moment to be like, you know what? Whatever's trying to distract me right now from doing this workout, I'm not gonna let it. and I'm not gonna let anything that's happened to me today affect me, because I'm gonna use that as an opportunity of growth and learning experience. All right, here we go. Drop it down halfway, push down into the ground, squeeze those glutes all the way as you get to the top, and then breathe through it. So just imagine what your life could be like, what it can be like from today, not tomorrow. What can it be like today is if you just take a deep breath when something happens, and you go, wow, how do I get to learn from this? How do I get to, you know, change my perspective? How do I get to have more fun from the things that I'm learning? Because when we know that life is always happening for us, our perspective can change and we can wake up every day excited and not anxious about the day ahead of us. All right, squeeze all the way up to the top. Nice work, everybody. We're gonna bring one foot in front of the other, bringing that little heel up off the back. So let's start off with that left leg in front, with the right leg in front. We started off with that one the same time. So let's keep that consistent. We're gonna squeeze those glutes. So really think about all the weight wants to be on that front leg. So push down into the ground and then tuck those hips underneath. So I'm typically using 45 pounds. So whatever you're using right now, just make sure that the last couple of reps are challenging, because we're going at a slow pace right here. If we have got lighter weights, typically we're gonna do higher repetition and less weight. All right, here we go. All the way down. So come down to halfway through your shin. Now push down to that ground and then squeeze those glutes underneath. Breathe through it. Inhale through your nose and exhale everything out. Nice work, everybody. You're doing so good. Stay the course. Stay strong all the way down and then bring it all the way back up again. Woo, that's it. Feel that tension. Keep it right there in the hamstring. Give me one more. Squeeze the glutes and gently switch over to the other side. So really think about all of that weight and that front leg. Think about stretching that hamstring. It's gonna feel really good as you stretch it out. So lifting up through the chest, pull that core in nice and tight, keeping that front leg straight. Give me one, practice one. Make sure that we're back engaged right here. All of that tension is on that front leg. 3, 2, 1, let's go. Take it down, push it into the ground, and then tuck those hips underneath. That's it. Whoo, how are we feeling? How are we doing? There's a couple of things that you're thinking about, like, oh my goodness, if I didn't need to react like that, how would I feel? How would my day go? How much happier would I be? How much energy would I have? Because how many energy balloons do we really have in a day? I'd say about 7. That's because 7's my lucky number. So if by in the morning you've already got upset because your shaker's spilling, it's spilled everywhere, the traffic, and then you get to work and, you know, somebody's complaining at you, you've already dropped 3 energy balloons just by letting things get to you, and it's not even 8 a.m., right? So think about protecting your time and squeezing those glutes. That's it, protect your time and squeeze your glutes. All right, we're gonna take it into those arabesque leg lifts. So bring one weight down to the ground, holding that weight nice and secure, pull that core in nice and tight, and we're gonna take it up and down right here. Again, you know I talk about it all the time, but relax that foot so we get all of the tension, boom, into your booty right there, into those inner thighs. That's it, here we go, all the way up and take it down. So if you lean forward just a little bit more, you'll start to feel it in the glute on your right leg too, the leg that is down on the ground. Pull that core up nice and tight. Now remember, just 40 seconds of exercise, so stay focused and use a weight that is going to push you, that is gonna get you a little bit outside of your comfort zone. Pull belly button in, lean forward a little bit more, and know, like, think about it, every single time something is coming up for you, something happens for you, just think, how do I just take a moment? What do I get to learn from this? Like, how is this gonna be so good for me? And if we think like that and we come up with a positive, you're gonna have way more energy throughout the day and you're gonna be way happier, all right? Who raise your hands if you're like, hey, I would just like to be happier every single day? Well, you are in charge of your own happiness, and that's what it's all about. All right, we're gonna take that leg up and down. Same way they on the other side. Make sure that you don't kick your tree. And here we go, we've got this. 3, 2, 1, lean forward just a little bit more, taking that leg all the way up and squeeze. That's it. So think about using the leg, right? You're using your hamstring to lift your leg up, not just leading with the foot. Oh, whew, all right, we got one more exercise after this and finish off this round, and then we are gonna keep on cruising through, my BTES family, those of you on the app. Whoo, we got a great second half. We got some new moves for you. All right, that's what it's all about, adding in more variety and testing ourselves with new exciting exercises. All right, 10 seconds to go right here. Pull that core up nice and tight. Now, can you just lean forward just a little bit more? Push that heel into the ground, lifting that leg up. You've got this for 3, 2, 1, and release. Grab hold of that other weight. We're gonna take it nice and wide into our wide deadlift with those heel raises at the top. So both feet facing towards me. You're gonna slight bend in knee, very, very slight bend. Take it all the way down and then raise up onto your toes. Here we go. 3, 3, 2, 1, let's go. So take it down and then all the way up onto your toes. Control, that's it. Feel that stretch first of all in the back of your thighs, all the way back through the back and those hamstrings, that's it. Feel that stretch. Very slight bend, less of a bend, less of a bend. Feel that stretch. Raise all the way up onto the toes. Pull that core nice and tight. Inhale through your nose. Exhale everything out. Come on, you've got this. Push down into those heels. Tuck those hips under and breathe. That's what it's all about. And those moments are gonna come to you that are gonna be challenging. Just breathe through it. I'll put on a workout, right? Put on this workout. Get your mindset straight in the right direction. Give me the one more. Lift all the way up to the top. Hold and gently release. All right, how are those hamstrings feeling? We're gonna come down to the ground. New little fun exercise that I've got for you. So pop your weight out to the side. We're gonna come up as if we are gonna do one of those fun little tricep dips. So bring your hands directly underneath your shoulders. We're gonna push all the way up. You're gonna extend one leg out and you're gonna pulse it up and down right here. So you're gonna flex the foot and really feel it in the back of your leg. Here we go. So working on those hamstrings. Push down with that supporting leg lifting up through your chest. Now really flex the foot to feel that burn alive. Here we go, we've got this. Now lifting up through your chest, modified version if you want to, if you need to with your hands, just come down right here. You're just gonna feel it a little bit more as you come up onto the top of your hands. If those wrists hurt, you can always hold on to weights at the same time or bring your hands into an actual fist. All right, here we go. If you haven't given it a go right up here, whoo, I tell you what, it feels so different when you come all the way up right here. Here we go, all right. Lift up those hips just a little bit more and squeeze, that's it. 3, 2, 1, and release. All right, we're gonna take it straight over to the other side, so shake out those legs. So what you wanna do is you're not gonna bring those hips up so high, they kind of wanna be in line with your leg as it's extending out, but hands wanna be directly underneath your shoulders right here. You're gonna extend up, and you're just gonna pulse right here. Right, just do one little practice one. Feel like I'm saying practice one? I'm just giving you guys a little bit of a head start. All right, here we go. Push down into the hands, lifting up through the chest, squeeze those glutes, and extend that leg nice and long. Just keep breathing through it. Every single time that you feel like you can't keep going, just say to yourself, can I give myself 5 more? Can I push myself? Can I see if I can? It's the same where you're in an environment where things are going crazy or chaotic and you've got to deal with something. It's like, how can I just breathe through this? How can I remain positive? How can I remain having great energy? Because I don't want anybody else to take my great energy away. I'm not gonna stoop to somebody else's level, right? We're gonna hold that integrity. We're gonna hold that standard and we're gonna keep that energy alive. Let's go for 3, 2, 1, and release. All right, if you want to, you're gonna dare yourself, bring in those 2 weights. We're gonna take it into bridge up and down with walk in and out, all right? So bring in your weight on top of your hips right here. Bring it all the way up. You're gonna take it up, down, then you're gonna walk out. 1, 2, 3, 4, hips up, and then you're gonna come all the way down. I like to hold my weights right here on the edge. Makes it a little bit more easier on the holding. All right, here we go, a little easier. Here we go, up, up. And squeeze those glutes. Now take it down, almost as if you're gonna touch the ground. Push those hips all the way up again. Extend those legs out and bring them back in again. Hips are nice and high. Take it down and then squeeze up at the top. You've got this. Extend, 1, 2, all the way up. Push those heels into the ground. Gently take it down. Pull that core in nice and tight. Here we go. Oh yes, backs of the hamstrings. They are on fire. Backs of the legs are burning. We got this. Come on, keep it going. Less than 10 seconds to go. Squeeze all the way down, tucking those hips underneath. Bring one more, all the way, and release. Okay, you're gonna come back into that original position that you were in when we were working on that leg extension, and we're gonna take it across the body, right? So bring those hands again directly underneath the shoulder, lift all the way up, extending that leg here, you're gonna take it across. So just think about straight ahead, and then out to the side of your mat. Flex that foot, working the underneath of your leg. You're gonna work a little bit on the inner thigh at the same time, just lifting up through the chest. Remember, modified version, you can come down right here and taking it across, bringing those arms all the way down if you want to, just relaxing those arms, you're still gonna feel it in the inside thigh. Here we go. But if you bring up onto the hands, you're gonna feel it just a little bit more in the upper body, or you're gonna get that burn working those triceps at the same time. Or right here, if you just wanna focus on those thighs, that's it, we're gonna take it here. You've got 10 seconds left to go. Inhale through your nose, exhale everything out, give yourself a smile. You are gonna work through the things that are facing you right now by creating great energy around you. All right, we're gonna take it over to the other side. So extending that right leg out, if you want to, give it a go, bringing up here. You're just gonna work that upper body just a little bit more and to create a bit more strength. So give your hands a little bit of a shake. We got 10 seconds right here until we get into it. So bring those heels up off the ground, lift up in 3, 2, 1, let's go. Bring it in, so straight, and then tapping on the outside of your mat. Push down into the fingertips, lifting up through your chest, and then squeeze. Inhale and exhale. One little thing at a time, that's all we're doing. We're just building onto this workout. Bring the heel in and out, squeeze. You're doing so good, everybody. Well done. I am so proud of you. We wanna keep on pushing forward, but every single time that we come to our mat, we're learning more skills. We are finding that things in life do not have to be as challenging as we decide. Those little struggles, they're gonna become mini struggles. Those big struggles will become small struggles. 3, 2, 1, and release. Okay, shake out those hands. We're gonna take it again one more time on that set. Then we've just got 3 exercises left. We're gonna take that 2 times in our round. So your legs should be burning right now. We're gonna bring it all the way down here in our second time that we do this, really just to focus on the inner thigh. But if you wanna keep working on that upper body, you can at the same time. So here we go. We're just gonna take it into pulses up and down. Really flex the foot, and we're just gonna pulse it out. That's it. So tiny little pulses right here, lifting up through the chest. You're gonna start to really feel it in the inside thigh. So just make sure that your shoulders are down, you're lifting up through your chest, you're pulling that core in nice and tight. Flex that foot just a little bit more. Here we go, come on, that inner thigh is on fire. We're working it, we're making it happen for ourselves. This is what it's all about. You can create strength in workouts that gives you the belief of how powerful that you can be in the rest of your life, right? Your personal, your health, right? Your relationships, all of those other areas. Give me 3, 2, 1, and release. All right, extend that other leg out. Woo, give yourself some extra credit just by doing a static hold right here. Shake out those hands and shake out those legs. A little bit of a shake, come on. Here we go, we're gonna extend that right leg out. Now squeeze the leg, really flex the foot. The more that you flex the foot, the more that you're gonna feel it. Drop those shoulders down, lifting up through the chest, and here we go, pulsing it out. Little pulses, the smaller the better. That's it. Now focus. What has happened to you recently where you could have maybe just gone, how could I have looked at that a different way? And it's not about beating yourself up, it's about reflecting and learning, because we can't change the past. The last thing you wanna do is go, oh my goodness, I can't believe I did this, 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 and this. No, it's all about looking forward. Do not keep looking back. When we keep looking back, we are living in the past. We wanna live in the future about what is coming up next. Here we go, you've got less than 10 seconds to go right here. Here we go, you've got this for 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and release. All right, bring those weights all the way to the top. We're gonna bring it down right here. We're gonna bring those weights right here and just hold onto them onto the side right here. It's gonna make it a little bit easier to hold onto those weights. So we're gonna push down into the ground. We're gonna come all the way up, and then we're gonna walk those legs out and then all the way back in again. 3, 2, 1, let's go. Do not be late, let's keep this up. You can have some water in just a moment, but let's keep this momentum right here. I wanna keep that burn alive in the backs of your thighs. All the way up, squeeze those glutes, halfway down, and then all the way up. Yep, all the way down. We're gonna come up to the top. That's it, come down like an inch or two, and then squeeze those glutes. Extend those legs nice and long. Get that full extension right there. The more that you extend the legs, the more that you're gonna feel it in those hamstrings. Take it down, extend, inhale, and exhale. Here we go, push those hips up to the sky. Come on, all the way down. Squeeze those glutes one more time. Extend those hips up, gently down, the last one. Extend those legs out and bring them all the way back in, and down we go. All right, gently roll all the way up. We're gonna take it into that final exercise for this set, and then we have one more little routine to do. All right, here we go. So we're gonna take it up onto our hands right here, extending that leg out. We're gonna take it right in front and then out to the side, or you can come down onto your heels right here. So think about little tap right in front and then tap just a couple of inches off the outside of your mat. Bringing up through your chest. We don't wanna just like sink down right here. We wanna lift up and then taking it right in front and back. Breathe, you're doing so good. Feel that tension right here. If you want to, you can add in a band. You can put the band from your heel all the way through to your thigh. You can add on an ankle weight. I tell you what, you're doing this with our new ankle weights that are coming. We're working on it, right? And then you're gonna feel it even more. All right, we got this. 10 seconds left to go. We're gonna switch over to the other side, and then we're gonna come up to a standing position. 3, 2, 1, and release. All right, bring those knees in towards your chest. Give yourself a little bit of a cuddle. extend those legs up, feel that stretch, and then let's take it over onto our final side right here. Extend that leg nice and long, flex that foot, bring those elbows directly underneath your shoulder, and then take it out and in. We've got this in 3, 2, 1, let's go. Tap in front, out to the side. Whew, breathe, inhale through your nose, exhale everything out. Think about the squeeze in your hamstrings, the squeeze underneath your thigh, in your thigh. That's it, out to the side, little tap. Do not quit, keep the body moving. You feel like quitting, just do 5 more. When you feel like you've done 5 more, do another 5. That's it. Bring it in and out, just an inch or two off the side of your mat. 15 seconds to go. Let's keep this up, pulling that core in nice and tight. Now you can start to feel the burn. Flex that foot even more for the final 10 seconds. Let's go. You've got this for 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and release. Okay, gently come all the way up to standing. We're gonna take it into one of my favorite exercises. We're gonna take it into a single leg Romanian deadlift. All right, so here we go. We're gonna bring one. You can hold on to both of your weights if you want to. The heaviest weight wants to be in the opposite hand to the leg, right? So if I've got my left leg, that's gonna be nice and straight. I'm gonna bring my right arm and I'm gonna take it all the way down, keeping that foot nice and flexed, and then all the way up. Make sure that foot does not turn in, go out. It's gonna go straight back, halfway, and then all the way extend. That's it. Now focus on something right in front of you. It's gonna work on your balance, on your core, and then feel that stretch all through your hamstring, the back of the thighs. Let's shape them up, let's sculpt them gently all the way down. Take your time, control. Foot is straight back, do not turn your foot in. That's it, my trainer's always telling me I'm turning my foot in, so I'm focused on that right now. See, even when we do not have, you know, we're fitness, we're working fitness, right? We still have trainers. Everybody needs a coach. 3, 2, 1, give me one more. Come on, extra credit, and release. Okay, whoo, shake out those legs. I'm gonna take it over to the other side. So push that foot down onto the ground, lifting up through the chest, and we're gonna take it all the way down and squeeze all the way up again. All right, here we go. Whew, looking good, everybody. Right, you got 3, 2, 1. All right, so just think about hinging. It's all the way down and hinge. That's it. So think of nice like seesaw. As your head comes down, the leg comes up. Lift that leg up just a little bit more. That's it. So body comes down and leg comes up just a little bit higher. That's it. Keep that balance, keep that control. Lift that leg up just a little bit higher. You'll feel it even more in the backs of your legs. Here we go, working on that hamstring, working on shaping and toning up your thighs. Push down into that ground, spread those feet nice and wide on the mat. Take it down gentle. Yes, you've got this. Breathe through it. Inhale through your nose. Exhale everything out. If you are not feeling this burn right now, you gotta increase your weight. Give me one more. And release. I'm feeling it right now, just with 5-pound weight. All right, we're gonna take it into a fun little squat, single leg squat with a heel raise. So you're gonna come right here, you're gonna squat down, and then you're gonna lift all the way up onto your toe. Or modified version, you're gonna bring the weights just down by your side right here. In fact, even though they're gonna be pretty challenging, you can just take out that extension all the way up to the top. So modified version, you're gonna come down into that squat and take out that raise. You wanna just test it out. Here we go, all the way up and down. Woo, yeah, here we go. So take it down, squeeze those glutes, lifting all the way up to the top, and slowly, 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 come down. That's it, push down into the ground, and then lift all the way up. Guys, we've got one more exercise after this, and then you are completed. Push it all the way down, tucking those hips under, lifting up nice and tall. Right, 15 seconds to go. Breathe, inhale through your nose. Exhale everything out. Modified version, you can either just bring that foot down to the ground if you wanna take that heel raise at the same time. 3, 2, 1, and release. All right, shake it out, shake it out. Woo, all right, we're gonna take it over onto the other side. So think about, what was it that you wanted to get when you started this workout? What was it that you wanted to achieve? We're gonna bring that right leg right in front, right leg right in front. Let's stay controlled, let's stay focused. We're gonna take it down and then squeeze and then up onto our toe. 3, 2, 1, let's go. So sink down, keeping that chest lifted. The only thing that is going down is those legs. So push that knee out to the side. Stand up nice and tall. Squeeze the glute, then raise up onto the toe. I know, it's challenging, it's tough, but this is what we're finishing with. We're making it happen for ourselves. All the way down, slow and controlled. Coming up onto your toe and slowly down. Come on, focus. What was it that you wanted to get out of today's workout? What was it? How are you gonna quit just because it's getting a little bit tough? No, this is what life's all about. It is happening right now for you. So push through it, it's teaching you something. 5, 4, 3, 2, One and release. All right, we're gonna take it into our plie squat. So you're gonna bring those weights on top of your thighs right here. We're gonna tuck those hips underneath. We're gonna come down and we're just gonna squat right here and pulse it out. All right, here we go. Stay focused, stay connected, stay with me everybody. Squeeze those glutes, lifting up through the chest in 3, 2, 1. Here we go, push those knees out to the side. Tucking those hips underneath. Inhale through your nose and exhale everything out. Woo, that's it. I always remind you, you gotta keep on breathing because otherwise you're gonna get dizzy. All right, we're not getting the oxygen to the muscles. Push those knees out, push down into the heels, squeeze those glutes. Remember, you're sitting right down. You're not pushing your booty back. We're working on those inner thighs. 20 seconds to go right here. We're gonna take it into one more set of Romanian deadlifts because they are my favorite. And then we are gonna cool down and stretch it out. All right, all the way down, push into the ground, lifting up through the chest. And squeeze, come on, tuck those hips underneath. You're going straight down for 3, 2, 1, and squeeze. All right, final two exercises, right? Well, we got one exercise, we're just gonna do it on either side. Take into those Romanian deadlifts because they are absolutely my favorite. So we're gonna do them together. And here we go. We're gonna start off, we're gonna put that left leg forward. Let's just do one practice, one together. Flex that heel, hinge down, and squeeze. Nice work, everybody, here we go. Come on, two more lots of 40 seconds of exercise, and then we are completed. Really push that heel going backwards, lifting up through the chest, and then squeezing those glutes underneath. Every single time that you do a rep, it counts. Every single time that something happens for you, it counts. You're gonna look back and be able to connect all the dots. But if you are just not riding with how life is, if you're not allowing the rhythm of your own life just flow and enjoying every single moment and seeing what happens, whew, it's not gonna be easy, right? Life does not always have to be so hard. We make it harder by how we react to things. And squeeze, all right? So that's what we're gonna focus on today, is when you have things happen for you in your life, you don't react in such a way that maybe you did before. And I was the first person to do that, reacting in a way that just didn't help me for the rest of the day. So, final 40 seconds, everybody. Let's give it everything we've got for 3, 2, 1, and let's go. Now lift up that leg a little bit higher at the back. Sometimes this leg, this side, I always forget to just raise it up. So lift up that leg, you're gonna feel it even more in the back of your thighs. We're working on sculpting that hamstring. Woo, it's gonna help get that back booty nice and perky. Squeeze. Give me a little tuck of those hips at the top. Lift that leg up just a little bit higher. Make sure that foot doesn't turn in, it just goes straight back. Push down into the ground and tuck those hips under. Here we go, so strong everybody. We got this. Keep your body moving. Inhale through your nose. Exhale everything out. So good, everybody. Give me a couple more reps all the way down. Give me one more, your best one yet. And squeeze. Nice work. Woo! Well, if the backs of your thighs are not on fire, I'm not sure what you were doing right there, but go back and do that again. Maybe add in some weights and resistance bands. I only have 5 pounds and I can feel it. Let's stretch out. We got 2 minute quick little cool down right here. Let's bring that knee in towards your chest. Have a couple of rotations, left and right, and just breathe. Bring that knee in towards your chest, take it across the body, and bring that arm out to the side, feeling that stretch all through your glutes, all through the side of your, yeah, nice side part of your outer thigh. That's it, take a breath in, try and keep both of those shoulders on the ground, that's the goal right here. And just congratulate yourself on getting through this workout, maybe learning something new today that can help you tomorrow, or even help you today. Bring that knee in, that's it, a couple of little rotations left, and then take them right, and then bring that knee in, taking it across the body in a supine twist, both of those shoulders on the ground, and then looking over to the opposite direction, and feel a nice little stretch too in the back of your neck, all the way through the back of your spine. Breathe in, and exhale, bring those knees in towards your chest. Come into a happy baby for me. Interlace your fingers through your toes and just sway from side to side. Feeling that stretch all through the inner part of your thighs. Oh yes, even though we were aiming for the back of the thighs, you're still gonna work a little bit on the outside and the inner at the same time. Bring those knees together, gently roll up. We're gonna come into a child's pose. Bring those knees out to the side, to the edges of your mat, and then release everything down. Feeling that stretch, getting that booty to heel connection. We're gonna keep that chest lifted up right here. Bring those knees a little bit further out to the side. And just sit down. Oh, take a nice big breath. Inhale. And exhale, bring your hands up. We're gonna bring one leg out to the side, final stretch right here. That's it, flex that foot, bring that left arm all the way up, take it over to the right, feeling that stretch all through the back of your legs. Flex that foot a little bit more to feel that stretch to the extra level. Inhale, and exhale, take it all the way over to the other side. That's it, bringing that leg up, flexing that foot, feeling that stretch right here, lifting up that right arm. Inhale through your nose, exhale everything out, and just breathe. Nice work, everybody. We did such a great work today. Just keep this up, keep this momentum. Bring out through your chest, lift up and relax over. And gently come all the way to standing. Gently come up into a halfway lift. Inhale, halfway lift. Exhale, forward fold. And gently come all the way up to standing. Woo! Bring your arms over the top of your head. Remember what you learned today. How can you implement that? One, you're gonna feel those hamstrings tomorrow. And two, just remember, tomorrow, when something happens, it's for you. You did an amazing job today. I'm so proud of you, and I can't wait for our next workout together.